Hello and welcome to our next webinar with the topic IBAS Tool Benefit in Practice. My name is Thorsten Reibel. I'm sitting here together with Jürgen Schilder. We will share this webinar. Let's start. IBAS Tool Benefit in Practice. What is our agenda today? So of course, we would like to talk about this service tool we have for many years already, so it's not completely new, but it's a very powerful tool nowadays, and it will be updated all the time. So we thought it's good to give you the actual status of the software right now with some facts and figures and some features together with practical demonstration of some products. And last but not least, we have also an additional small topic, the ETS app KNX Bus update. We mentioned this already in the last webinar, and now we would like to make it a bit more transparent. Is also a small demonstration. Good, so tool, it's our own ABB tool. You can download from our homepage, abb.com/knx. Behind services and tools and engineering tools, you will find some information about this service tool. And of course, you can download the tool also here. And keep in mind, it's free of charge. So everybody can use it and download it free of charge. And you will see in the next hour how useful it is and what can be done with the features inside this tool. Yeah, if you remember, maybe we have done already exactly 3 years ago a webinar about this IBAS tool. So it's not completely new, as mentioned. So we gave already some general information. If you want, you can have a look here as well. It's not lost. In our training and qualification database, you will find all these former webinars, the video file, but also the slides. So if you want, you can have a look here also to this basic, let me say, webinar around the IBAS tool. Yeah, what is the task or the target of this tool? In principle, it supports system integrators during commissioning and service. So it's for our ABB KNX devices. Only for our ABB KNX devices, so it's a unique tool only from ABB, for many products from ABB, not for all. You will see later on an overview of all supported components. A unique tool which gives a lot of benefits for the system integrator to work with our products. In the practical phase, during commissioning, testing, and any maintenance or service activities. And as you can see here on the right, in principle, we need a PC. A Windows PC where you have to install this tool, and then you can assess KNX devices, twisted pair KNX devices, via standard interface. We will see later on via the physical address, but also IP, KNX IP devices can be assessed. But all this I will show to you later in practice. Yeah, if you assess a device, you can have internal information about this device, any status information. But you can also trigger some functions and test anything. We will see later on as well. The IBAS tool is an option. It's not a must to work with this. Though, to be honest, if you work with our DALI KNX gateways, it's more or less mandatory. Makes life much easier. And if you don't use it, it's not, let me say, very practical. But in principle, not really necessary. And but it's very helpful, as you know, and as you will see in the next hour. Important is that we do not change anything in the programming of the KNX devices. So what we are doing with the ETS and still necessary to do with the ETS will not be changed. When we take any action, when we trigger any function, then we do the same. You could do also via the bus, via a telegram. Yeah. So for example, if I change via the IBAS tool a scene, which is possible, then it's also possible to do via any telegram from the KNX side, from via the bus, for example. Yeah, to assess KNX devices, you need a standard interface, as already mentioned, can be the USB interface, but also IP interface or IP router can be used. The same principle as you know from the ETS. And if you connect via the physical address to one device, then a product-specific plug-in will be started in the IBAS tool. So an individual, let me say, screen or many pages or screens will be available for the product. Yeah, again, to operate something, to test something, and to see any status information. Yeah. So it's really product specific what you see here, very different depending on the product. Yeah, and then the system integrator, the installer, the person who's commissioning, can trigger any functions, read values, simulates any functions, and as mentioned, can also change scenes if available via bus. All these things can be done. In principle, it's only necessary to download the physical address to get access to a device. So not really necessary to download the application and any group addresses. But you have to know that if you have not enabled in the application different specific functions, maybe you cannot see it here in the IBUS tool or cannot trigger these functions in the IBUS tool. Visible here in the screenshot of a shutter actuator, yes. On the right side, you see here there are two fields grayed out, means there are further functions behind or information, but at the moment not available because it's not enabled in the ETS application. There's also an interesting help function in the IBUS tool. I will show you live later on. Yeah, as you know, our KNX components have a very powerful application, ETS application nowadays, where you can adjust a lot of things. Yeah, and of course, and you download what you have done, and for sure you have to test, is it working properly? Of course, you can also try to test directly in the ETS to send, for example, a group address to trigger any function. And then you see in the group or bus monitor, for instance, any feedbacks. But it's not that user-friendly. It's not very graphical. It's a text-oriented display. So it's a one option, but even better is to use our IBUS tool. Yeah? For example, here with the shutter actuator example, so you can operate all the standard functions like going up and down, or you can simulate or activate any security or safety functions like wind or rain, which results also in a further action in your KNX installation. And so a lot of things are possible to simulate instead of using real components in the system you might not have up to now, not yet programmed, or to work with this group or bus monitor in the ETS. Yeah, the software can be downloaded from our homepage, as mentioned. It's very simple to install. It's a file with some further files inside you have to copy only on your PC. You start tool.exe, and then you have already the IBUS tool available on your PC. Different languages can be adjusted. Updates can be created or downloaded also. I will show everything in live a bit later. And then, of course, normally you work then with the component and test everything. If it's not properly working, maybe then you go back to the ETS, change any parameters, enable any further function, you test again with the IBUS tool. Yeah? Important is that you have only access to one device at the same time via one physical address. So if you have done your job with one component, you shut down the connection and open maybe another product via the other physical address. So only step by step with one product I can work in the IBUS tool. Yeah, important is to know which components are supported by our IBUS tool. As mentioned, the software tool is not new, so it exists already some years. And what we did in the past, all new devices launched are supported by the IBUS tool. Yeah? I think there are hardly any exception where we do not support this IBUS tool, but when it makes sense, and in most of the cases it makes sense, we will integrate the new product in our IBUS tool. And so you see here the overview of all KNX devices from ABB which are supported. And the software version number we have right now is 19110. And maybe in the next future, and together with our new DALI gateways for sure, we will have a further version with integrated new DALI gateways, for example. Yeah, and you see here the overview, analog actuators are supported, our recently launched product logic controller, ABAS, analog inputs, all the DALI gateways, our energy module, an ocean gateway, also here small information later, our fan coil actuators, yeah, you can also test here together with the IBUS tool. We started years ago with our shutter actuators, line coupler, was also shown a bit by Jürgen, light controller mainly for calibrating constant light control. The same we can do also with our DALI constant light controller here, very important and very user-friendly to do. Energy actuator, our intelligent diagnostic power supplies are supported by the IBAS tool. And last but not least, weather station and weather unit, where you have also some interesting functions also later on shown by Jürgen. What can be done here? Again, will be updated continuously depending on new products. There's also demo mode inside the IBAS tool. So if you would like to see only in principle how it looks like with one supported KNX device, but you don't want or you cannot trigger any functions at the moment, you can have a look here as well and see in principle how it looks like. Maybe you would like to show it to anybody. Then you need no real running KNX installation behind. In one of the former slides, you have seen the connection to the KNX twisted pair devices, but also IP devices. KNX IP devices are accessible via the IBAS tool. And it's very simple. We have a special button. You click on this IP devices, and then all detected and, of course, also supported KNX IP devices will be shown here. Yeah. The functionality with these components is not like twisted pair devices where you can trigger a lot of functions or read a lot of status information. It's mainly for components who have a web browser functionality behind to open the web browser directly here. So it's not necessary to type in a web browser the IP address of this device. You can assess the web browser, for example, from the security panel directly via this IBAS tool. You can also detect devices here by flashing the LED. If you have many KNX IP devices, many IP router, for example, in a distribution board, you're not quite sure which components is which one, easily detectable here. You can also restart a device in the IBAS tool. And for some components, it's necessary or might be necessary to update the firmware. It's also possible here via the IBAS tool. I will show also a bit of this in my practical demonstration later on. Yeah, supported IP devices is less, of course, because we have less IP, KNX IP devices compared with twisted pair. But our typical devices, IP router, IP interface, also the more or less phased out telephone gateway is supported, a very old IP gateway, and more current devices like security panel and also, of course, our recently launched logic controller ABS is available here. A very important, or maybe the most important part inside the IBAS tool, is the integration of our DALI software tool. In former times, it was a separate tool, but since we have this IBAS tool, we integrated also this DALI software tool. And more or less, here it's mandatory to work with this IBAS tool together with the DALI software tool inside to, let's say, program the DALI part of our DALI KNX gateways. You remember this, to detect the DALI addresses, to change DALI addressing maybe, to create DALI groups, all these things you have to do here in this tool. And I will show you later on from our new DALI gateways coming next month, and which will be also the content of our next webinar end of April, already some interesting features. So you get already a preview of the DALI part here, of the new DALI gateway inside the IBAS tool. And you will see something which you know already, but you will see even more. Some more interesting features now, underlining at the moment how important it is to use our IBAS tool, especially together with our DALI gateways. Yeah? So fault messages are also available. More information you will see later on. But wait a moment, I will come back to this a bit later. Configuration I will show also. Configuration means of the KNX interface. It's like the ETS. You can choose the standard interfaces like USB or IP, IP interface, IP router. And this is very similar, in principle the same, like in the ETS software. Principle here, it's explained, but allow me to do this practically. So I will stop here with my first presentation part in the in this presentation. I go now to my desktop and show you directly in the IBAS tool how it works in principle. So I'm here in the actual version, which is, as mentioned, 1.9.11.0. And if you start the tool, what do you see? Two buttons, connect and update, check updates. And in my case, it's a green piece of puzzle, means I'm online. Of course, it's prerequisite that you are online, connected with internet. There are no updates available. If it's red and blinking, then you get the information, oh, there seems to be an update. And then you click here on this button and anywhere will be red here on the left. On the left, you see the more or less the core software and all these plugins for the different products, plus the 8 language packages. You see here the supported languages. And if anything is red, also here on the lower right side, update piece of puzzle, let's say, will be red. And then you click on this only and it updates now your software. Well, very simple. You get the information, can do it with one click only. As mentioned, this will be a continuous process to update this IBAS tool. Yeah, help. You see here the button help. If you click on this, you see on the right, a help text, but it's not only a help text in general. You see all the time, it's a dedicated help text depending on the screen or page you have opened, depending on the action you are taking right now. So it's really related to your action and is sometimes very helpful. Also for me, who knows, of course, a bit the IBAS tool, but sometimes, oh, how was it? I check it also with the help text. I keep it open at the moment. You will see later on if I go to some functions, different information here. Yeah, and below the menu, you have mainly settings, check updates, the same we have done already. Connection manager, we will see later. Ah, yeah, screenshot. If you want, you can create anytime. If you have any status information, any actual situation in the IBAS tool, create a screenshot, can store it. You see it here as a JPEG file. And maybe for any let me say, further information to our hotline, for example, oh, I've seen this. What does it mean in the IBAS tool? And you can send it then. Quite helpful sometimes. Behind settings, more or less the language, as already mentioned, refresh display. What does it mean in principle? It's a continuous communication between the IBAS tool and the connected KNX device. So automatically it will reads out the status and updates the information on the display. But that leads to traffic on the KNX bus. Yeah? And with a telegrams per second refresh rate, you can increase this or decrease this. You have even more traffic with 20, for example. If you don't want to do this, you can go to manual. Then you have to refresh the display manually with a refresh button here and to reduce the traffic if you need. But most of the case, you keep it in automatic mode. Yeah. Not much here. Let's go back to connect. Yeah. And yeah, then you come here. And if you click on connect to device, this principal window will be opened, which allows you to select already recently connected devices. You see it here, not only the physical address, but also the name of the product. Or you type in here in the middle, the physical address of the new component you would like to assess, very simple. So you have to know the physical address. If you don't know, okay, then you press a programming button and click here on scan. Scan means it looks into the KNX bus, is any programming button active, and then it displays under discovered the physical address. You can directly start or trigger here to get a connection. Yeah. So it's very simple. The connection manager is already shown in the slide, very simple. If you start the IBAS tool at the beginning, so after setup of the software on your PC, you have no interface active. In my case, already the USB interface is active. But I show you very simple to create a new one. So you have to create any new or any interface. By clicking on new, you will assign a name. In my case, I take the IP interface, which is also part of my training kit, which is on the left to me, to have real connection to the products. IP interface can have only IP tunneling connection. If you have an IP router, it's also IP routing, or the other one is USB, but in my case, tunneling. And if you click here on devices, I see more devices because I'm connected to the ABB network, and further KNX IP devices will be shown to me. So in my case, I know which is the IP interface in my training case via the IP address here. You see it also in the ETS 30. So this is my IP interface in my training case. I confirm this and of course save this here. And then a new connection is established. And if you look to the lower left side of the IBAS tool, you see down there under lock IPSS and the IP address. So now I'm connected via the IP. IP interface to the KNX installation and can connect, of course, now a component. Allow me to take only a short example. I take here my already connected shutter actuator. I click on connect, and then after some seconds, the connection to this device will be established. You see here already something. I don't go into details. Jürgen will show you later on some more details, the principle, how it works, and really with the product. So if you go back, or maybe have a help, look to the help on the side. On the right side, you see here is something different now. It's really to do with my shutter actuator and the dedicated information, help information about the functions here. But I go back now. Later, you will see a bit more. This IP device topic you see on the left, connect to device means via physical address and to twisted pair devices. Demo mode is clear to show only what is in principle available. Down there, supported devices, a list of all components. And under IP devices, I do it right now. I'm connected now to the ABB IP network. So all KNX, IP KNX devices, also from other colleagues in other rooms, will be shown here. You see a lot of application controller, ABAS is visible here, and many IP interfaces, IP router. I think that's the end now. You see in principle all connected devices with the main data. Okay, device name, physical address, IP address, MAC address, and so on. And if you click now on one device, have a look to my IP interface, which is 10.49.121.30. And then you see here on the upper side some features you can do. For example, this update function already mentioned, possible add some components to update the firmware if possible here. And you see it here on the right. Some components have this up-to-date information with a green marker, means these components can be updated and seems to be up-to-date at the moment. Genau. Okay. And if you click on a device, you find also on the lower side here some more details of these IP components. So it depends also here on the product and Another feature here is blink LED. So also to detect, as mentioned, components. So if I click on this and I say blink LED, then the component in my installation will be identified and shown via the blinking LED. Okay. I think it should be enough for this IP part. I would, just a moment. Maybe very short information about SBAS calculation. Many people ask, what is this? Just very short, it's only in brackets for our security panel GMA 8.1. There is a separate optional bus behind the security bus. I click on this, and this additional tool within the IBAS tool allows you to calculate the correct cable length of the security bus with connected security components in order to have correct communication. It has to do with cable length, with voltage drop. So here's a bit, engineering necessary in order to have the correct installation. It's only a specific solution here for the security panel. Good. I would stop here with the first part of this demonstration. I would hand over to Jürgen now.
Hello and welcome from my side, Jürgen Schilder speaking. At the beginning, I show you the state and information of some selected devices and followed by a practical demonstration how you can test the wave from the weather sensor over the weather unit up to a shutter actuator, how you can test individual devices and the complete wave. So what else you can do with the iBus tool is we can read out the data which are really stored into the device. For example, when you give a call to the technical support, the colleagues want to know the version of application which is really downloaded into the actuator. Like here in my example, I have the shutter actuator, JRA/S. So now I connect, make a point-to-point connection from the iBus tool to the device. And then here on the top, you can read or you can see in, for example, hex, for example, the device type, which is A061, which means in reality, this is here my shutter actuator JRAS42351. Okay, this is the version of the hardware, and you can read here also the version of the software of the application, the 1.3, and the name blind roller shutter 4-fold 230 volt with travel detection M for manual operation 1.3. So this is a really nice feature to read out the version of application which is really downloaded. When you see here, for example, the version 1.2, and then you can go on our website, download the latest version, version 1.3, convert the former application 1.2 into the 1.3 and make a download. And then you're really up to date. Good, what else? We can make we can get some more information from some devices, like for example, the power supply with diagnostic. These power supplies, the SVS 30, 320, 21 or 645.1, they have a bus coupled unit inside and an ETS application, so they can send also some commands, group telegrams to the KNX bus, like for example the bus voltage or the bus current. And via the iBus tool, we can read out more information, more than we can have on our KNX bus. One is, for example, the operating hours. So here you can see the operating hours of this power supply is now 4,123 hours. When you divide it by 24 hours, then you get the operating days, for example. Or the operating hours since the last startup. So I switched on the power supply, the energy to this power supply before 741 hours. So when you see here maybe only a short or a small number, two or three, then you know, okay, 2 or 3 hours before there was a power failure, and the power comes back. And a nice information is here the number of startups. How often, for example, the supply voltage dropped down and comes back, like here in my example, 37 times. And the N-Ocean gateway is the gateway. We can also connect here up to 32 channels of N-Ocean devices, and per channel we can have five devices. And via the iBus tool, you can see the signal strengths of these N-Ocean sensors. Like for example, here my channel number one, and here on the right side, you see the details of this maximum five devices per channel. You see the signal strength, so when you press one button of the sensor, and then you see here the signal strength of device number one, for example, is good. And here of this device here, it's red, or it's a little bit weak, maybe you have to change the position of the sensor. And additionally, you see here the ID, the unique chip ID of each single N-Ocean device. So with this view here, it helps really during commissioning where you have to install your sensors, that you have here a good signal strength which comes here to your N-Ocean gateway. So for constant die control, you have to do the kind of calibration process during commissioning. You can do it via ETS, the group monitor. You can send commands, group telegrams, start a calibration and so on. But it's quite easier to use the iBus tool. So how you can do it with the iBus tool is when you have a look on our webinar, which we have given in September 2014. In this webinar, we have a practical demonstration and of course an explanation given how to start or how to do this kind of calibration process. The day and the artificial light calibration and these single steps and how it works to have a good data, a constant light calibration. So go on our website and go to the training and qualification database. There you can find the presentation and of course also the webinar recording. So the line coupler is also sometimes a very device which sometimes can make problem when you want to make a download or to program a device, the individual address from one line into another line, and you have and it fails, you get messages, device does not respond or something, then it's also important to read out the parameters of the line coupler. You can see the parameters in the ETS, but it's better to use the IBUS tool and to read really out the parameters which are really downloaded into the line coupler or area coupler. So at first you see here, for example, the filter table. What about the filter table? If the telegrams are filtered, which should be used default, then use the filter table, or all telegrams are blocked, or the telegrams are routed. So we have it in both directions. So on the left side, you see here from the line to the secondary line, which means from the main line, for example, into the line, or from the secondary line, the lower level, yeah, into the higher level, which is, for example, the main line or our backbone line. So you see here the parameters, and like here, for example, this one, the main group 0 to 13, you see here it is blocked. This means no group addresses passes from the main line into the secondary line, the line coupler. So when you have a central device in the main line, like a weather unit, and this unit sends a telegram wind alarm into the lower level secondary line, that the shutters, for example, should drive in a safety position, it will not work, because here all group telegrams are now blocked. So, or what about physically addressed telegrams? It can be also filtered or blocked. And physically addressed telegrams are now used when we make a download of the application. So when you click on a device, press the button, download application, and then the ETS makes a point-to-point connection from the USB interface to the device which receives the application. And when here, for example, physically addressed telegrams are blocked, then it's not possible to make a download via line coupler or area coupler. And another parameter is here broadcast. What are broadcast telegrams? You can also block or route it. And the broadcast telegram is a special kind of group address, which is 000. This is a special broadcast telegram. In the ETS, it's only possible to create a group address which starts with 001, but you cannot create 000. This is reserved for broadcast communication. And we need this group address to program the individual address of a device. So in the ETS, when you click on the button, download individual address, and then the ETS sends broadcast telegrams into the KNX installation. And when, for example, here, or if here, the broadcast telegrams are blocked, then it's not possible to program the individual address in another line. In this case, please change here the parameter, download the application, and then it should work. And you can also read out the filter table, so the group addresses, which are added automatically to the filter table and passes from the secondary line to the line. So click here on this button, filter table, and then you get the overview of all group addresses. You can select here, also on the right side, there's a button to see the three-level addresses, the two-level group address view, or also the free address range. What do you want? So let's come to another practical use of the IBUS tool. When we use our scene controller, typical 8-bin scene controller, it means with 8 bits we can call up to 64 scenes, or we can store up to 64 scenes, new values. So in the ETS, we enable, for example, the scene function in our shutter actuator. We say, okay, here my output number A, which is here, for example, the blinds in this room, I want to use a scene function. When I call the scene, I want that here my shutters are exactly here in the position 50%. So for me as a human being, I see here on the top, here I have 0% and here 100%, and it should stop here at 50%. But in reality, we have here no 50% because the shutter drives deeper than here our window frame. It starts here on the top. We have some delay times and so on. That's why when you set here parameter 50%, you will not see it really at 50%. It will be more up or more down. But how we can solve this situation? Use the IBUS tool. Go to the IBUS tool, next equation. Connect the device with the IBUS tool, the shutter actuator. Via these buttons, drive up and down the shutter and the position that you have really 50% like you see it at the moment. Press the button stop. Go here to the menu scenes, select number of the scene, scene number 4, and then press here the button store. And then this position, which has the shutter motor at the moment, is stored in our actuator when we call scene number 4. So the next time when you call this scene number 4, he drives really exactly in the position like you see it in 50% between your top and the bottom of your window frame. So it's very easy to do it here via the IBAS tool. So what else? Safety and weather alarm. So like here, we have a typical shutter control situation. We have a sensor to control manually up and down or drive up and down here our shutter and blind motor. And we want to have here also a weather station outside or the weather unit and the weather sensor. So when we have wind alarm, for example, we want that the shutter drives in the position up. When we have rain alarm, he should drive, for example, the position down. But what happens when we have both wind and rain? Then we can set a parameter of priority in our shutter actuator and say the highest priority has wind alarm and the second priority rain alarm. And the third priority can, for example, be frost or something else. So, and we have another parameter, what should happen when the wind alarm now is going, or the weather or the rain alarm. Yeah? We have the reset of the weather alarm. Should the shutter keep this position, or should he go to the position before wind alarm? It's also a parameter. And we want also another feature, the cyclical monitoring of the information which comes from our weather unit. So, for example, the weather unit can send a live signal every minute, no wind, no wind, no wind, and the shutter actuator can cyclically listening to this telegram. And when the telegram does not arrive every minute in the shutter actuator, then the shutter drives also in a safety position, for example, up. So, but how we can test all these parameters, the priority, the behavior, wind alarm, rain alarm, and such things? Very easy. We use the IBAS tool, and via the IBAS tool, we can test here our shutter actuator and the weather unit. I will show it you later. Another situation here with our shutter actuator is the so-called sun protection. We want to have more functionality. We want to have a kind of automatic sun protection, which we can start or activate or deactivate via one rocker or time switch, for example. And then our shutter actuator is listening to the weather station if we have, for example, sun or no sun. So we have outside the weather sensor. He measures the brightness as a 2-byte value also to test it. And now we can do it via our IBAS tool. So at first, we go in the IBAS tool. We test all the settings of the shutter actuator. And then we test all the settings in the weather unit. So now I show it you now in a practical demonstration. Let me share the desktop. Just a second. Share my desktop. So at first, I go to the IBAS tool. I have done all the settings in my shutter actuator. I have also assigned group addresses. So some important features, for example, here and the parameter for all channels. We have here the weather alarms. I have here set user-defined values, for example. I have here the priority of my alarms. You see, the highest priority is the wind alarm, then the rain alarm, and if you want, for example, the frost alarm. I have activated the wind alarm for my communication object number one. So this is linked with my weather unit. And then I go here to my channel A, say here safety, to the parameter safety. And now I set the parameter what should happen when we have wind alarm. For example, channel A, wind alarm, he should drive in a position up. When we have rain alarm, he should drive in a position down. Frost, it's at the moment not used. And for example, do we want to use also the block function, for example, or forced operation, yes or no, and the priority or the order of priority when we use, for example, the weather alarm, the block, and the forced operation. So these are the settings I have done here in my channel A, plus some more, for example, for the sun protection. That's why I go here to the menu A functions, sun automatic sun protection. I have enabled it. And here I have to set the parameter, the position of for when we have sun. So the weather unit send the command sun, and then he drives in the position of the height 70% and change the angle of the sled up to 50%. The position is for no sun. So when the weather unit says no more sun, then he drives in the position up. So these are the values for sun and for no sun. Good. And when we want to use the scene function, we go here in the function scenes. I enable my different scene and say, for example, my scene number 4, go as a default value 50 and 80%. And later via the IBAS tool, we can change it really that we have the optical 50% in our window. Good. So far, the settings of my shutter actuator. Then I go to my weather unit. I do here the settings. At first, for example, for rain, So we want to use the rain sensor. So we have to enable the rain sensor. And it's not difficult. Rain is only one bit information. Rain, then he sent the group address with the value 1. No rain, then he sent the value 0. A little bit more parameters we have to set when we use the wind speed, because the sensor sends the wind speed as a 2-byte float value to the bus. But 2-byte float, the shut actuator cannot listen to 2-byte float. He needs a 1-bit information. That's why we need here the so-called threshold function. We have two thresholds per wind speed meter. So I click here on threshold number 1 and set here as a default value my value or my limit for my lower limit, for example, 25 multiplicated 0.1. So we have here 2.5 meter. So if we have less than 2.5 meter, we send a logical 0 on the bus when I selected here 1-bit information. And more than 5 meter per second, 50 multiplicated 0.1, then he sent a 1-bit information on telegram, which means wind alarm. So brightness, we want to use our sun protection. So we have it also here, the value of the brightness as a 2-byte value from 0 to 100,000. And we have to do the same. We use a threshold function. And here we set as a default parameter like 10,000 lux for our lower limit and for our upper limit 20,000 lux. And when we, for example, exceed our 20,000 lux, then he send the on telegram. And when we fall below 10,000 lux, then he send the off telegram. With this information, sun or no sun, the shutter drives in our default position. Good, after I have done the settings, link via group addresses, the shutter actuator and our weather unit, the objects for wind alarm, rain alarm and so on, download all the settings, and then we can use the iBus tool to test all these parameters. So let me start the iBus tool. So where's the iBus tool? Go on the button connect. I have here at first my three devices, my shutter actuator. I click on the button connect. So now the iBus tool makes a connection point from the USB interface to my shutter actuator with the address 113. And I see here in a kind of yes visualization all the parameters which I have enabled in my ETS application. You see here the heating and cooling automatic is gray shaded because I have not activated in the ETS. So very important when I want to send commands or to do some things, at first I have to go to the configuration mode. That's why. So we have here on the top a button, select configuration mode. I said confirm, yes, and then I can send commands into my KNX installation. So for example, I can here drive up and down my shutter, or when I click here, he drives in the position up. I can press the stop button and then the motor stops and send me here also the feedback, 81%, for example. So can I drive the shutter up and down, see the wiring is okay, and for example, the power of my motor is okay, MCB, everything is fine. What I can do also is, I can drive it here in a position, I can take via the sliders or here plus minus, I can so drive to the position 44%, and then he drives exactly to my 44. You see here the status, current position 44. I see here no wind alarm is active, no priority, no forced operation, no motor error, everything is fine. And here on the bottom, I have the possibility to simulate my alarms, my maximum 3 wind alarms and my rain alarm. Now I activate my rain alarm, click on the button activate. You see here on the top, the rain alarm is now blue. It shows that the rain alarm is active. And here we see a red icon that one of the alarms, it is weather or safety, now is active. And you see here drives in the position down 100%. So now what happens if we have additionally wind alarm? So we have both wind and rain. And then the highest priority is wind alarm. And then we can see if it really works. When the motor drives in the position up, and after some seconds, he reached the position up, you see here 0%, and then we are sure, yes, we have done the correct settings of the order of the priorities. So when the wind alarm is now deactivated, then he drives in the position for rain alarm, which was down. Then you will see he drives, now the motor drives in the direction down, because we have now rain alarm, and rain alarm was the information drive down. And no more rain alarm, I deactivate the rain alarm. And now you can see we have no more alarms, everything is fine. And the motor keeps this position because this was my parameter. Do not drive in a position before wind or rain alarm. Keep the actual position at the moment. So next step is I have to test the automatic control. We have here the button automatic control. I activate it and I see what happens. It drives in the position for no sun because at the moment we have no sun. And remember, the position of the sun was drive in the position up. You will see here is in the position 0%, which is up. So now with this button, I can simulate sun. Like he receives the information from our weather unit sun, and then you will see he drives in the position down, and he stops at, for example, I think 70% was the default value for position sun, and the angle of the lamella of the sleds 50%. No more sun, and then you will see he drives back in the position up. So with these steps, I have tested all the settings of my shutter actuator, behavior for wind alarm, rain alarm, yeah, and my automatic control, and I'm sure that everything here is okay. And here, this is the example for the scenes. For example, you drive here via the buttons, the motor, up and down, for example, in this position. Say, okay, now when this is really in the middle of my window, I press the button stop. Yeah, and click here on the button, select my scene, scene number 4, press the button store, and then this 49% is now stored in my shutter actuator. And when the next time I call scene number 4, the motor drives here in this 49%. And for me, I see it is really in the middle of my window. Good, so far, test all the settings of the shutter actuator. We go back and test now our weather unit. So weather unit, the address 114, connect to the weather unit. So now the IBAS tool reads out all the settings of the weather unit. So just a second, please. No. Come on. No. So we have to wait. Okay, so we have here our general information, but I would like to show you the feature for rain alarm. So I click here on the left side, rain. So let's a little bit zoom here. For rain, I activated a configuration mode so that I can send telegrams into to the device. And now here I can enter a value between 0 and 1. When I press here, enter the value 1, and I say right. And then the weather unit believes that this information is coming from the weather sensor, which is outside installed. But I simulate this value. And then the weather unit sends to the KNX via the group object. You see value overwritten. This is my KNX object. The value 1 to my shutter actuator. And then the shutter actuator drives in the position for rain, which was, for example, down. I can test here also the wind speed sensor. I can simulate here a value, for example, 4 meters per second, write this value, then I write this value into my weather unit, and the weather unit believes that this value comes from the sensor, but in reality it comes from the IBAS tool, and I see here I have not exceed my upper limit, only because my limit at the moment are 8 meters per second, and I can say, okay, 10 meters per second, write, and then I exceed here my upper limit. I see my threshold works, and I send the value 1 to my shutter actuator, and he drives in a safety position, which is, for example, up. I can go back, say, okay, only 2 meters per second. Then I fall below my lower limit, and he sends information, no more wind alarm, the logical zero. And via the sliders, for example, here, I can change here the threshold. I select a new threshold, for example, 6 meters per second. Click on the button right, and then my new threshold for wind alarm, I have changed it now, is 6 meters per second. So via these sliders, we have really possibility to change the thresholds. We have not to use the ETS. Yeah, it's easier to do it here in the IBAS tool. So no more wind alarm. We can go back to rain, say no more rain alarm. And then we will see that our shutter drives in the position or keeps this position because we have no more alarm. Good. Brightness for our automatic sun protection. So the same, we have here our lux. You see at the moment 103 lux. This is like the sensor measured it here in my office. I can change it, for example, I say maybe I want to have here 25,000 lux. click on the button write, and then the IBAS tool writes to the weather unit this 25,000 lux. And my weather unit believes the value comes from the sensor, but in reality, it comes here from my IBAS tool. And then I can also see I have now exceed my upper limit, and he sent the value 1 to my shutter actuator. It is sun, and then he drives in a position for sun, which are our 70%. Or I say here, for example, only 1,000 lux, right? And then we have no more sun. You will see I fall now between the lower level, yeah, and he sent the value 0 to my shutter actuator. So and with this steps here, we have tested the complete wave. We have simulated the weather sensor by the IBAS tool. We have tested the thresholds in my weather unit, the thresholds for brightness, the threshold for wind speed, and then the weather unit have sent the group addresses to my KNX world, to my shutter actuator, and we have seen the shutter actuator really drives in the positions like we want. And so with the IBAS tool, it's not only to test a single device, we can test also the complete way from the weather sensor over the weather unit to my shutter actuator. Good, so far some steps, the practical use, how you can use the IBAS tool for testing. And now I hand over again to Thorsten. Just a second. Okay, Thorsten, it's your turn.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. As promised, I would like to show you also some additional things in the IBAS tool. So I go direct to my desktop again. And now I open another version of my IBAS tool. It's a demo version for our new DALI gateways. Our next webinar will deal with these new DALI gateways. They will show some more details about this product already. But we thought it's good to show you already here in the IBAS tool the actual or very soon available version of our DALI gateways to show you, to underline how important, how powerful it is to use the DALI part here in the IBAS tool, and to see what kind of information will be available. It's more than before with the existing devices. And as mentioned, more or less, it's mandatory to work with the IBAS tool here for our DALI gateways. Makes life much easier and it's very helpful. So I connect now to the new DALI gateway, DGS16411. And to show you, give you already the first information how it looks like in the IBAS tool. So I connect. Take some seconds to get a connection, to read out some values. Yeah, and then here I'm in the IBAS tool together with the new gateway. So I enlarge the first screen a bit, and you see on the left some more parts now in our DALI gateway, more than the existing devices. I'm really connected here to a KNX installation with my DALI gateway, and 6 DALI ballasts are connected. You see already in first information, there's no lamp or ballast fault. Everything is fine. My DALI installation is running quite well. The DALI gateway has a running power supply, green indication. And to show you that also any activity will be shown here, Jürgen, could you please press the button for manual operation on the device? So manual operation was not running at the moment, but now Jürgen activated here. There's a manual operation immediately shown here, and I can only operate manually, and we deactivate this again. And then, of course, I have normal operation. So things like this. If we go to the next part here, then it's, I have to reduce the size a bit. It's again similar to this, what you know from the existing DALI gateways. Principle here, this array with 64 icons representing possible 64 DALI ballasts. And on the right, these 16 DALI groups you can create. Yeah. But if you look on one icon here representing one ballast, you see a lot of more information. I don't go into details at the moment. Explain here. For example, let's take this one. Oh, I do it after, I create a group. Let's create a group first of all. I create a DALI group, as you know already. I click here on, I have to activate, of course, first of all, the configuration mode. You see, if I do something, which is not working, it informs me here with a blinking button select configuration mode that I have to do first of all something. So I activate the configuration mode. So now I'm really online and I can take action. And you see, if I click here on group number one, I can in this case remove these two lights because they are were already assigned to this group number one, or I can edit with a plus sign. Yeah? So, and the legend again gives you some more detailed information about this individual ballast. I will explain it then in the next webinar in the 26th of April. But here we have even more information. Yeah? Also on the right, some more new information. For example, here at the end, you see an information more than 64 DALI or 64 devices detected. No, in my case, I have only six, of course, not more than 64. But it happens in practice that due to any extended installation, you have more than 64 ballasts. And you have no correct identification of the ballast, of course. And then you see directly here with yes, oh, there's something wrong. I have more than 64 ballasts. Yeah? So more information is also the topic here. And if we go to overview, you see in this case all six ballasts which are connected in my group and the actual status. You see the group number one is switched on, brightness 100%, contains ballast number five and six, and of course both have also 100%. The others are off, and any further function like staircase function or burn-in mode might be active will be shown here. And also further status information, let's say. New will be the following under detail. So each group I have created maybe, or each ballast connected can be operated here as well. Yeah, so I can switch on and off. In my case, group number one is on, of course, I switch off. Yeah. So you see, actual value is zero, but I also can dim here. So there's also new, not only switching completely on off, but also dimming of each ballast is now possible via the IBUS tool, for example. So now I go to 42%. Yeah, and further status information, but also you see here, burn-in mode, I can activate. Yeah. If I activate burn-in mode means dimming will be disabled. Yeah. Then you see the light goes to 100%. Means no dimming, only 100% on or off is allowed in these burn-in modes. You can simulate also here the burn-in mode or activates this, yeah, or deactivates this. Yeah. So only the first impression, again, to enhance how important it is to use our IBUS tool together with our DALI gateways. And again, this is a unique solution only ABB has to do mainly the DALI part with our IBUS tool, with our gateways. And it's a real benefit advantage for many of our customers, and there's a new version of the DALI gateways improved, let's say, but more in 1 month in our next webinar. Okay, I would stop here.
Good, I think we have now finished the IBUS tool, but we have another software tool which we want to show you now what you can do, how you can use this software tool. It's a so-called KNX Bus Update app. This app is available on the KNX Association. So you have to go to myknx.org, log in with your user account, and then you can download this app. This app is, of course, free of charge. It's only you have to do some steps. You have to go here to the shop, and you have to place an order, and you have to press here the button buy. But do not be confused. You have not to buy, pay something. It's only to do some steps to get here the license file, the app, and then it works. So please do it. It is, you see, free of charge, costs nothing. So, and then this app is installed inside the ATS. And via this app, you can update ABB KNX devices, like, for example, the presence detectors and the new DALI gateway, for example, of course. Yeah, and you need so-called update files. Yeah, these update files are so-called, so these update files are so-called FWUPD. You can download these update files from our website and import these update files to this ETS app, And then you go to the device, select the device, and start this update procedure. And depending on the size of this file, it will last maybe 1 minute or up to 15 minutes. Yeah? And as this time, the bus is really occupied with telegrams. So let me show you these steps in reality. Go to share my desktop again. So close here my... So I'm now back here in the ETS. So at first, install the ETS, download the update file. I have here in my line some devices, like for example here the presence detector 6131/21 presence detector mini. So now I must be connected online to my presence detector. So the first step is to program, of course, the individual address of this device, and if you want, also the ETS application. So then we go here to the button extras app KNX bus update. So click here on KNX bus update, and then a new now window pops up, the so-called update app. Select here device type. This is not a test version, ECU, what you see. Select here, for example, your device. Okay, select here 115, press on the button reload. And then, okay, you see, you find in my KNX installation my presence detector with the address 1115, again the name 613121, the firmware version, which is now at the moment inside the presence detector, and you get the information that the update here is possible. Before, I had imported here the update file, so when you click here on the button, update import file, and then you get here the selection of all files which ends with FWUPD, import it. Like here, I have done with the version 019. I select here now my presence detector. Yeah, you see the update is possible. I click the next step here on this button, update firmware, and then the ETS makes a complete update of the firmware of my presence detector. The ETS application and the group addresses are not touched. So after the firmware update, you have still all parameters and all group addresses are now available. It's only maybe of some bug fixing or more features inside, and then it may really make sense to use this update tool here to our newer version. Not only here the presence detector, also for example the DALI gateway and all KNX devices in the future. For the information. Good, I think let's come to the end of this webinar. Some final slides. We have here 5 minutes past 4 o'clock German summertime. Summertime now. Okay, you remember our webpage abb.com/knx. Here you can find all information about the KNX system, about the different products, our service tool. You can download the iBus tool and of course these firmware update files for the KNX bus update app and so on. And here we have also the link to our training and qualification database and to our FAQ page. So here our training and qualification database screenshots. We have here our e-learnings, the webinar recordings, presentations. We have some other guidance about KNX free at home door entry system. Yeah, so we select here the different, for example, system you want and what kind of information, videos, slides you want to have. So news, also our FAQ tool, also for our complete product range. So here you can read more information when you have problems or you want to get deeper information. Then we have here different kind of topics, or you can go here on the search menu, write a short tag, and then you get a corresponding FAQ question. And of course, not only the questions, you get also the answer for your question. New is on our website, the so-called training and qualification calendar. So we have here our training dates for our training center here in Heidelberg and Lüdenscheid in Vitone, Italy. And we want also to show here all our KNX trainings on the website. Like for example, our certified trainings are also here listed in this training and qualification calendar. Some words about a certified training. We have next week here in Heidelberg another basic course, yeah, from the 3rd up to the 7th April. We have still 2 places are free, so if you have a customer or someone who wants to come next week, so please go on and come to this training next week from Monday to Friday. Our advanced course will take place in July and the tutor course, of course, in October. So far, I think we are really at the end of this webinar. I want to give you some information about the next one. Remember the date of the next webinar. It's still a Wednesday, the 26th of April. time in the morning, 9 o'clock, and at the afternoon at 3 o'clock, Central European Summer Time. And now we introduce you the new two DALI Gateways Basic DGS 1 or 2 6411. The features of the devices, we have only one single DALI gateway. We have integrated the DALI gateway 1.1, the 1.16 and the DGNS. All these three devices are here in one single housing. See you and have a nice day. Goodbye.